Alright. Alright, we're back with Armored Warfare. If the mic sounds a little different, it's because I got a little, it's like a fuzzy thing that goes on the end. I don't know what it does, but I decided to put it on. Came with, this Turtle Beach cord that I needed to use my, Turtle Beach with it, with, the Xbox One. Got the box right here. Because I have a Xbox 360's Turtle Beach that I use. And, you know, don't want to have to buy a new one from Xbox One. Yeah, just buy the adapter. That's all I did. Perfectly good headset. Why would I go buy a new one? It's a different one than I'm recording with right now. Well, but yeah, this is not going to be a gameplay video. Same person who asked me to do the other tree evaluation asked me which vehicles to skip. Which ones aren't worth it right now. If you're looking, I am going down the BMP line, even though I said it's not worth it. It's because I kind of want to shoot. I never got to play the BMP 3M. I didn't get there last time I played. In the alpha, they locked every up to tier 6, but a lot of these vehicles have changed since the alpha and a lot of them moved around up and down, and there's some new ones, so I'll go through and just say which ones I think you should skip. We'll start with this side. If you don't like wheeled vehicles, I'd skip the LAV-150. It's not too worth it right now if you don't like wheeled vehicles. If you're good at controlling wheeled vehicles and moving around and flanking and all that, go for it. Don't skip the swing fire yet, because they're adding it so that it can launch 2 missiles in rapid succession, like the Bradley. So it has like a sort of salvo thing where you go fume, fume. So that's an early access 4. So that they're doing something with it. It was in the patch notes Silent Stalker put up on the forums. I'll put a link down to that in the description of what they're changing between now and then. The Fox is great. The VBL is great. The wheel's great. Stuff to skip here. I might say to skip the M60 Starship, but right now, because it can get into games with much. Last night I was playing a lot. I got pretty far through the BMP3, and all it was there were so many high tier tanks that anyone in M60 Starship, because the Starship only fires heat, they did almost no damage because newer tanks have anti-heat armor. So, you know, if I would say don't skip it. It depends. It's a weird tank to get used to. If play one game in it, maybe. If you don't like it, skip it. I mean, there's not that much in terms of upgrades for it. I mean, you get one upgraded heat, and well, you will have to do it to get the hull reinforcement Mark II. I mean, it's kind of weird skipping vehicles now because some unlock stuff. Like, look, enhanced sight interface Mark I. You have to play vehicles in order to unlock some of the retrofit and equipment. They fixed the Leopard 2AV. I know, because one was just bouncing shots all over the place in this one game. So everything here is good. They're fixing some stuff with the Abrams. I said artillery is not worth it to go down at all unless you really want to play artillery. I might play it. I mean, skip anything here. Hold on a second. Where were we? Sorry about that. So basically, who is it? The lady's blue line here is a lot more lines that are worth it. This one. Yeah, I think that's a Swedish lady tanks or something. Yeah, but everything but the artillery. Never go or don't go artillery. Until they, I haven't. I'll have to find something that says what they're doing about the counter battery system, because it makes playing artillery almost useless sometimes. All right. Yeah. So everything's worth it. I don't think you're. This one, maybe this one. No, the L-40 is pretty good. It has no armor, but. Oh, and the BMP-1. If you can't get used to the BMP-1, because it's a very, very weird vehicle. I mean, it fires RPGs out of its gun, basically. They're very slow, and it only fires HE and hash or HE and heat. So, and the HE does very little damage. If you can get into a game that's all scouts, this thing is great. Maybe versus some lower tier MBTs, but you can rip through the Leopard 1 with your heat rounds. All right, well that's everything. Maybe. LAV. Now it can do pretty good, but only when fully upgraded. Because. Yeah. Yep, only when fully upgraded, because you don't get a APFDS round till the last gun. So, focus all on. Since it's a tank destroyer, don't go for any of these other upgrades yet. Just go straight to the gun. All the gun, just to get this round. Because you basically need it. I mean, you're kind of in the same situation of the BMP, where you can only fire heat and HE until you get, the top gun. And when you do get the top gun, you get HESH. Or HEP. It's basically HESH. Same thing as HESH. So, yeah. There's no point to taking HE when you have HESH. Take heat, and take APFDS, heat, and HEP. I mean, HE is only for doing damage, but when you have APFDS rounds and HEP, there's no point. Alright. So, yeah. Don't skip the LAV-600 outright, just skip to the last gun. I mean, like I said, it's kind of bad to skip vehicles because they all give, you have to go through a vehicle in order to get the retrofit. Alright, this side. Well, you know what I'm gonna say. AMX-10P. Hate it. There's no redeeming quality about this thing. Unless they added something to it. But, look. It's barely even got upgraded ammo. It's just, you're there to. It's not worth it. This thing is crap. It's probably the worst tank right now. Unless the enemy team is just filled with lightly armored vehicles. Other than that, it's bad. BMD-1's pretty good. It has the same problem as the BMP, but you have ATGMs and you should have better heat rounds. Yeah, you got these. 166 millimeters of penetration, that's pretty good. Not really anything I'd say to skip in this line, besides the AMX-10P. This Scorpion's great, it's been moved to a light tank, it's pretty good. Sheridan's always great. The Bagel Panzer, or Belgian Panzer. I've seen people call it the Bagel Panzer. I think I started that on the forums. And then the Burger Panzer. I kind of like Bagel more. It's got a weird gun. And it's got anti-tank missiles, so it's pretty good. That's if you go down this line. But as I said, it doesn't go to tier 8, so it's not as worth it as basically every other line in this. I mean, this one even has two tier 8s, so. Let's see here. T-55 is new. I saw some people playing it. Seems to do all right. Not much in the way of armor, unless you're fighting an M48 Patton. But as soon as you get to a higher tier, I mean, 237 penetration, 197. How much armor you have on the T-54? Yeah, your armor means nothing. Yeah, 120. 120 on the hull. As soon as you meet a higher tier, right through. You have nothing. You might want to skip the T-64, get the retrofit, and skip it. Reinforced ammo rack, that's pretty good. But T-64, I felt, was much worse than the T-62. It didn't feel like an upgrade. T-72, nah, I wouldn't skip it. T-72A, it's the new one. It's got ARRA, it's pretty good. Nothing really to skip here. And nothing really to skip there. And just don't play artillery. Not because I hate artillery. I love artillery. Great, but because of the counter battery system, it's worth it, because especially in 3-shot ones like the Palmera and the Acacia, they fire 3 shots and then have to reload. Well, with the counter battery system, unless they changed it, I'll have to look. Every shot you fired, you got spotted. So if you went and fired all 3, you'd be spotted for basically those 3 shots, and you just die. Unless you were just counter battering with them. But just sitting there waiting for the enemy to fire, just so you can do a minuscule, like, 50 splash damage and not be helping your team, isn't worth it. If these vehicles are supposed to be support vehicles, I mean, they do have their new special rounds now, but not sure how much those are worth it. I'll have to play. I mean, as you can see, I almost have the Gavazica. So we'll see. I think that's it, because there's not that many vehicles in the game. Yeah, just don't go down this line. I just want to play the BMPs. I mean, I'm also going to unlock the tank destroyer branch so that I can go to the Striker and the Centurio 120. What they should have done is taken the Warrior or the Ramka and put it here or here, or have them both lead to one. You could put the Warrior right here, no problem, no one would complain. That's just my perception. I don't know if they can have two completely different lines lead to the same vehicle. See how these are like in one block? If you can have, I mean, like two blocks, like, I don't know. Oh, well, that's it. You're gonna get another video, probably of, some game. Maybe more Leopard, maybe I'll buy the Off-40, show you that more. But yeah, that's it for now.